Today, we are going to look at a BodyViz brain builder about the lymphatic system and mononucleosis. Mononucleosis, commonly known as mono, is a common disease among children and young adults. Mononucleosis has also earned the nickname the kissing disease due to its ease of transmission through bodily fluids such as saliva, meaning that kissing with mononucleosis can lead to contagion. Sharing food utensils or a glass with someone contagious can also facilitate spreading this disease. In this Brain Builder video, we will learn more about the anatomy of the lymphatic system, as well as the symptoms, causes, and treatments for mononucleosis. The lymphatic system is closely associated with the cardiovascular system and plays an important role in supporting it. The lymphatic system transports and monitors a specialized fluid called lymph. Lymph consists of interstitial fluid, macrophages, and lymphocytes. Lymphatic vessels carry lymph from the periphery of the body to the lymphatic system and then to the cardiovascular system. The three major functions of the lymphatic system are maintaining an optimal blood volume while regulating the composition of interstitial fluid, providing an alternative pathway for the transportation of waste, essential nutrients, and hormones, and producing and maintaining lymphocytes. Lymphocytes bear the responsibility of specific immunity, also known as acquired immunity. Acquired immunity develops gradually through exposure to pathogens, meaning it is not present at birth. Specific immunity comes in two forms, artificial and natural. Artificial immunity is acquired through vaccinations, whereas natural immunity is the result of ordinary daily encounters with disease-causing agents and pathogens. Lymphocytes are found within the lymphatic system, cardiovascular system, and the interstitial spaces of the body. Lymphocytes will initiate an immune response when a pathogen is encountered. There are three classifications of lymphocytes: T cells, B cells, and NK cells. T cells are the most abundant type of lymphocyte. They originate from the bone marrow and mature in the thymus in order to become immunocompetent or activated. T cells differentiate into various types of cells when properly stimulated to target antigens and enhance the immune response. B cells are the second most common type of lymphocytes. These cells originate in red bone marrow. Immunocompetent B cells can divide into two primary forms, plasma cells, or plasmacytes, which secrete antibodies, and memory B cells, which remain dormant until they encounter the same antigen again. NK cells, or natural killer cells, also have a role in the immune system by targeting foreign cells, normal cells infected with viruses, and cancerous cells that have infiltrated healthy tissues. NK cells release toxic granules to eliminate target cells. Next, we will look at the symptoms, causes, and treatments for mononucleosis, and then give a patient example. Mononucleosis is commonly caused by infection of the Epstein-Barr virus. In response to the virus, the NK cells within the lymphatic system become activated, initiating a chain of events that underlie the symptoms associated with mononucleosis. These symptoms, which can vary significantly, typically present for 10 days to 3 to 4 weeks. Mononucleosis is also typically marked by the presence of one or more of the following symptoms. Diagnosis of mononucleosis is typically verified by an assessment of the patient's symptoms during a physical examination. Laboratory tests, including a white blood cell count, can help determine if an infection is present. A heterophile antibody test, or a monospot test, can determine the presence of antibodies to the Epstein-Barr herpes virus. Unfortunately, no antibiotics or antiviral drugs have been found to be effective in treating mononucleosis. Additionally, there is no inoculation against the disease, meaning treatment will typically involve attempting to alleviate the symptoms. Symptoms can be alleviated by prolonged rest, drinking plenty of fluids, lozenges, and avoiding physical activities such as sports, especially in cases with an enlarged spleen. It is also possible to take non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, or NSAIDs. An important note, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs are commonly used for pain relief and fever reduction. In cases of mononucleosis where an enlarged spleen is present, NSAIDs may thin the blood and cause a rupture of the spleen. Acetaminophen, or Tylenol, does not have the same blood-thinning effects, marking it a generally safer alternative. Finally, let's take a look at a patient example. You receive your patient's file and take a look. Age, 20. Sex, female. Chief complaints, sore throat, fatigue, and fever. You invite the patient into your office for an examination. Your patient informs you that she has a rapid onset sore throat and intense fatigue. During the physical examination, you notice swollen cervical lymph nodes, which raise your suspicion of mononucleosis. You order a white blood cell count and a heterophile antibody test, which showed elevated levels of white blood cells and positive antibodies specific to the Epstein-Barr virus. You diagnose your patient with mono and recommend a treatment focused on symptom relief. You advise your patient to rest and stay hydrated. Importantly, your patient does not have an enlarged spleen, making it safe for her to take non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. Your patient regularly follows up with you, and you saw gradual improvement in her condition until relief. This is a classic example of mononucleosis. Thank you for watching this Brain Builder video. Please like and subscribe to our BodyViz channel, or if you are new at BodyViz, check out our other anatomy resources and schedule a demo at bodyviz.com.